What's going on, guys? It's K-Dub here with another episode of Crypto Zombie. Welcome back to the channel. Hope you're having an excellent weekend so far. A little bit boring in the cryptocurrency space. A lot of the top altcoins not really doing too well. There are some low-cap gems exploding right now, but Bitcoin, Ethereum, XRP, basically just going sideways. Now, we did get that minor rejection, right? We were saying maybe we could have had that potential breakout. We are going to continue sideways. You can see right here, though, I am anticipating a major move by the time we hit this yellow line, and I will tell you why in just a minute. Now, in yesterday's video, we spoke about the OG whales sending their Bitcoin, their cryptocurrencies over to exchanges, potentially looking for a major Bitcoin sell-off, but I did say that smart money is accumulating, and I'm going to show you today that that is more true than ever. And I think a lot of people are going to be shocked to find out what Bitcoin is going to end up doing, especially even within the next month. Could we be due for a Santa Claus rally? Well, I'm going to talk about that today. Also, the fact that the supply shock is definitely getting worse. And we probably just got some of the most insanely bullish news for Bitcoin ever. And this time it's actually coming from the US. So all that, if it sounds good to you, definitely stick around. Today's video is going to have to be a little bit short. I do have a lot of things I need to do today, but I couldn't leave you guys hanging. So please stick around to the end of this video. The more you watch, it actually helps YouTube's algorithm to basically let them know that you like the video. So thank you so much. We'll get right to the point. So basically, looking at what's going on, we do have that rejection still, okay? This is the third week now that we are looking for this rejection. It would be unbelievably, phenomenally amazing if Bitcoin could close above $19,400 by this weekend. If that happens, well, then that puts basically across the board the highest daily, monthly, weekly close, all-time close, and we are most certainly going to be heading to an all-time high. In fact, we could be breaking 20K come Monday if this pattern does play out. There is the potential chance of that bounce again around the 21 exponential on the daily, which is only sitting at about 18,000. However, I would expect that to get bought up quite quickly. So if you are looking to short, if you do think that this is a double top that Bitcoin is putting in, you know, right here with one top right here, another here, or potentially maybe this is one top and this is the giant second top, then you could be looking for a short opportunity. If we break below 18,600, there might be a chance we come down back here to some of these lower levels. However, I would anticipate a bounce, so I wouldn't be just sitting in a giant Bitcoin short. Not financial advice, you do what you want with your trades, but having a look right here, there is that potential we come down, we retest the support over on futures. However, I think we could have a very volatile Monday, but I do think that if Bitcoin does in fact open up and try to come down to close the gap, if it does, which I think it would be done coincidentally, I definitely think we're going to have a major, major rebound. Now, I just want to talk about the fact that tons of gold, and this is from Trust Nodes, tons of gold have been taken off of ETFs while Bitcoin's price has been rising, showing a striking correlation between the two. They say, according to JP Morgan and Chase, family offices and other funds are selling their gold exchange-traded funds for crypto with gold-backed ETFs, dropping 93% tons of metal worth some $5 billion since November 6th. And interestingly enough, if we actually go back, let's just go back to this chart and let me put the volume on real quick. You can actually see that we've had volume dropping off. We've had the crypto markets cooling off, not as exuberant, not as fanatical as it has been. And yet the price is still sitting above $19,000 at the time of making this video. Give or take, maybe slightly below, slightly above. So considering a lot of the excitement has kind of gone away, the fact that we're still sitting here, we haven't had the major crash, we haven't had the major sell-off, we haven't had the major, you know, wick all the way up to the top. We haven't, in my opinion, we haven't had the blow-off top yet. This shows me that the market is still extremely strong and we could be looking for a lot bigger move. And like Stanley Drunken Miller said, one of the most recent high net worth individuals to turn to Bitcoin, he admits, yes, I do own many more times gold than Bitcoin. But frankly, if the gold bet works, the Bitcoin bet will probably work better because it's thinner and more illiquid and has a lot more beta to it. And he also had this to say in an interview.
Can central banks just keep printing money because there's no one to foreclose on them?
Not forever, but maybe for a lot longer than we think.
And if they do, then what's going to be the downside?
The longer you keep the thing going, the worse it is.
And as the central banks continue to print the money, we have more and more individuals, retail institutions, high net worth individuals, publicly traded companies looking for places to allocate their funds to get out of the inevitable hyperinflation of the US dollar. In fact, I showed you this chart from Coin98 Analytics about Grayscale buying 55,000 Bitcoin just in November when there was only 27,881 mined. And if that doesn't blow your mind, we had PayPal buying 70% of it, and we had MicroStrategy buying 40,824. This is also, I mean, we're talking a 4x compared to the actual capacity that's coming out. And oh my goodness, 16 hours ago, Michael Saylor says MicroStrategy has purchased approximately 2,574 Bitcoin for $50 million in cash, according with its Treasury Reserve policy. And here's the kicker. They purchased it at an average of $19,427 per Bitcoin. Now, at that price, that means that they are actually currently down, since the price of Bitcoin is $400 cheaper than the price that they purchased it at. But that definitely tells me that these people do not care. They are not looking for the quick flip, right? And you can see right here, it actually is all provable. If we scroll down here, you can actually see, on December 4th, they did purchase, Bitcoin for this, et cetera, et cetera. So these guys are certainly putting their money where their mouth is. Oh, and if you didn't happen to catch probably some of the most bullish news ever, we did have this interview on Squawk Box with Brian Brooks, who is the acting comptroller of currency at the USOCC. So this is quite interesting. This is literally from the horse's mouth. And guess what they had to say?
Former boss at Coinbase's CEO Brian Armstrong sent out last week, and he said that the Treasury could be, quote, planning to rush out some new regulation regarding self-hosted crypto wallets before the end of the term. Is that true?
Yeah, look, and Melissa, rumors abound in Bitcoin more than almost any other place. What I would tell you is we're very focused on getting this right. We're very focused on not killing this. And it's equally important that we develop the networks behind Bitcoin and other cryptos as it is that we prevent money laundering and terrorism financing. So believe me, there's a balance here and it's going to work for everybody.
So that's a neither a yes or no answer to that. Should we be expecting some new regulations by the end of the Trump term?
I think you're going to see a lot of good news for crypto by the end of the Trump term. Some of it's going to have to do with banks connecting to blockchain. Some of it's going to be more clarity around the nature of these assets. So believe me, there's going to be very positive messages coming out. At the same time, it's a dangerous world out there. We have to be honest about that. But nobody's going to ban Bitcoin. Nobody's going to ban some of these transmission technologies. I think it's going to be a lot less bad than people were worried about.
Well, I have to say that finally puts the nail in the coffin. No, the US is not looking to ban Bitcoin. In fact, he says there could be a lot of good things to come out for cryptocurrencies relatively soon. And something that is happening, the world's first Ethereum ETF is undergoing an initial public offering at the Toronto Stock Exchange under the ticker QETH.U. So, big news for crypto. Hope you guys enjoyed today's super short video. Like I said, I do have to get on out of here. I do have some things I need to do. But that being said, hope you enjoyed today's somewhat quicker update of a video. I will be back tomorrow with a little bit more analysis. We'll have a better idea of where Bitcoin price could potentially be heading into Monday. However, I do expect some extreme volatility followed by an all-time high. That's just what I'm looking at. But we will have to see. No, we're not going to crash, guys. Come on. You guys know the trend is your friend until the end. Buy the dip, right? That being said, that is it for me today, guys. Thank you so much for coming back to the channel. I do appreciate all your support. If you are a new subscriber, definitely, just want to say thank you. And if you're not subscribed, what are you waiting for? We do this every single day. So you guys rock. My name's K-Dub. This is Crypto Zombie. Until next time, stay crypto. And of course, peace out.